So what I'd like to accomplish is just by getting on here and sharing my thoughts and feelings about my experience that other people can find healing or encouragement from something that I share. And I hope that it affects people in a positive way. Also, in the spirit of the Black Box, I would like to share a poem that I wrote a very long time ago. Forgiveness this week brought this poem up to me, and I wrestled with myself whether I wanted to share it or not, but I would be hypocritical if I didn't, so I will. And it's called Preacher Man. Lord, may this help somebody. This is like, my stomach is in knots. I don't really share my poetry with people. And so, this is a lot for me. As they say in the church, take all mistakes for love. There is something to be said about your sermon, Preacher Man. Mixed messages of clean sin making me sick. Hungover from the love we communed with, I know the truth even if you will not admit. Repentance is the first step of forgiveness. Truth is but a still whisper in the dark, silent drops in the bucket of our souls that we are charged to obey. But too often we ignore it for more gallant signs of thunder or rustles of wind. Coos and whooping from the pulpit drown it out. That is more radical, but not as pure. Lies are far more appealing, or so I hear, but I know the truth. I sung your praises every chance I got. Chain smoked your lies until it ruined my voice raspy. I was water, rippling under your touch, crisp, calm, flowing into whatever you wanted me to be. I yielded myself at your will. Until you damned my progress. Supple lips dripped sweet sermons in my ear. You knew things I did not. So I took, ate, and fell. Muddied my water, deliberately disobeyed, unapologetically killed myself for you. Covered myself in darkness because I was not afraid. I did not tell. I was not tricked. I took your hand and walked to the tree, followed your lead until you stepped out of my reach. There are things too black about me, sides too round to box. We cannot coexist. How can light and darkness share the same house? You're too good, too pretend, too clean, too neat, too shame, white sheets, red letter. You're too King James, too holy, too called to answer Sunday morning for what we did Saturday night or Wednesday in your office, downstairs in the corridor. The doors of the church are always open. Arms too weak to shoulder responsibility, so instead you tore the Bible. I used to profess your gospel, allowed you to possess me. A prophet from the revelation of myself. I'll be your John, just love me. What's greater than love? I wrote the book. I hold for you. Let down my nets and fish for any compliment I could conjure up. I'm sure you fed thousands with that fish I love you bait. But you forgot the bread. Yeast helps us rise when the shit gets hot, but you sunk in the middle when I stumped in front of the stove. Stay out the kitchen. I need bread. Something thick like to stick to my bones when life starves us. You were not enough. I am bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more greedy. It's funny. I learned this black from you. I owned our sin. Someone had to die, so you strung me up. Took so much care, cleaned me dirty, forced me filthy, turned me to wine, perfected, refined with time, more butterfly than wine now. I'm no longer bitter. Should I thank you? You taught me sin, preacher man. We played in the garden you condemned together, watered it with our tears. Doth thou forgetteth me? I've been cast out of the garden, but the promised land waits. You can remove me from the garden, prune, prick, plant new seeds, repent, marry your new Eve, but you have the same fruit on your tree. And let the choir say, amen.
So my first question would be, is what political ideology do you embrace at this time?
Well, that's a wide question. But essentially, I'm an African woman who believes in freedom and justice, social justice, political justice, economic justice for all people. I believe in that oppressed people, wherever they are, have the right to self-determination. I believe that socialism is an integral part of building social justice on this planet. I believe that the priorities of this planet have to be completely changed. And instead of profits, instead of policies that destroy the earth, that destroy the water, that destroy human beings, I believe a policy that protects people, that makes people live in a community, a world community. That's what I believe. That's my basic political commitment at this moment.